Hello, welcome to my channel. My name is Ellen, and today I have a title that might make you question my mind. My title of today is Even if you have free time, even if you have a vacation, you should be on a schedule. And I have reason to say so. First, being on the schedule doesn't mean you should be busy and in a locked schedule from 8 to 5 every day when you have a day off. And I'm not talking about 8 days of vacation or even 2 weeks. But as a lot of us learned in the last year, we cannot really deal with having longer periods of times off. Most of the time, it starts in about the third or fourth week of not working, not going to school, that we leave our path. And as I said, I'm not talking about going to bed a little bit later, sleeping a little bit longer, or binging TV when you finally have your well-deserved vacations. I'm talking about us being at home for more than 3 or 4 weeks. I'm talking about the quarantine time, of course, being unemployed, being in retirement, being a student or a teenager who has summer vacation, people who are sick for a longer period of time. All of them experience the same. It really doesn't matter about your status. It doesn't matter about your age. It's just how humans are. Because when I'm the same. When I have vacation, the first week I just enjoy to do absolutely nothing, and it doesn't matter if I'm at home or if I'm visiting somebody. I'm really neglecting any way of responsibilities. I don't want to have to be anywhere at time. I like to sit at the breakfast table for 3 hours and binging one of my TV series or whatsoever. And that's absolutely fine, as I said. But we all know the longer it takes, the more it goes downhill with us physically and mentally, which means after you go to bed later and later and later, you start to eat worse, so to say. A lot of people do not care anymore what they eat. They consume more and more fast food or convenience food. They eat less fruits or raw vegetables as they usually do in their daily schedule. They don't move that much, no matter if they are quarantined at home or if they could go outside. Actually, they don't do any sports. They start neglecting their cosmetics. They shower less, they groom less. The clothing question goes more and more down the hill. Just let's mention Zoom meetings without pants. One of my favorite things during quarantine, watching all these videos. I really enjoyed it because it's so human. That's how we are. If you let us loose, we go loose. So the thing is, as I said, it's well deserved and it's fine. But the negative results show up pretty soon. It starts with we don't do any sports, and our eat habits get worse. So what happens? A lot of people develop skin issues, pimples, and spots on the skin. You gain weight because of moving less. It needs more and more effort to do anything, and I'm not talking about doing a marathon, but sometimes even getting up and loading the dishwasher or getting your laundry done. It's too much effort, and oh, I don't need it, and I need to change my clothes tomorrow so I can do the laundry at the weekend or the day after the weekend. And okay, I have wore this t-shirt 3 times or 4 times, doesn't matter, nobody sees me, and it all goes in the wrong direction. So your appearance goes a little bit down the hill, and including all this, it comes to also mental issues, because oversleeping isn't really healthy at all. Oversleeping can make you aggressive. Oversleeping can even make you depressive. It can give you digestion issues together with the bad food and the less movement and the less physical exercises you do. And really, nobody wants to know what happens when you eat bad stuff, don't move. We know it. And the next thing is, the longer you are at home, the harder it gets to go outside. Because at any time when it's about facing the possibility or the need to go outside, and you stand in front of your mirror, and that's what we all do, and then you suddenly see, like through a magnifying glass, how your skin changed, how your hair's changed. You see every gram you gained. Suddenly you don't not feel comfortable in your clothes anymore because the shirt's too tight, the pants are not closing, you have to loosen your belt for more than one hole, and it feels uncomfortable. You don't like the formal clothes anymore, as you're used to jogging pants and leggings and so on, and it feels uncomfortable to go outside. And so we question ourselves about the reasons. Do I need to go outside? I can order whatever I want. And do I really want to put me in this uncomfortable position? I don't think so. You very often skip going outside and you order, and that only rises the barriers for you to go outside. Because after feeling uncomfortable, there comes a kind of anxiety. What if people see how I'm looking now? How if somebody looks at me and faces how fat I've got? I don't want so many people around me anymore. I remember as when I got out the first time after quarantine, and I'm living in a really quiet corner of Berlin. I'm not really in the center. I really felt it was all too close, too many people, too loud, too much input. I thought I would enjoy being outside, but actually it was a really uncomfortable event. And for the second and third time, I almost had to force me to go out. And that's what happens to all of us. And you don't go out, and the barrier gets higher and higher because it wasn't a comfortable experience. And who wants to bring himself into uncomfortable experiences? So you push it away and away, and it gets harder and harder. And when you're at that point and recognize it, it's really important to make a stop, to make a point and change it. Or you're smart enough to change it from the beginning on, and I'm not really talking about a tight schedule. Let me tell you what I'm doing. I'm a night owl. I would like to go get up at noon, but I know I will be working at any time, and that's for me the reason one of the reasons to keep in schedule. And what should also be a motivation for you, because life will go back to any kind of normal, any variety of normal. And the further you are away from having a schedule, the harder it will be for you to get back on track, and the more you will suffer them. So it's easier to prepare in an easygoing way that's adjustable, so the next step wouldn't be that hard for you. So I get up in the morning between 8 and 9. I limited my breakfast time down to 45 minutes. On the weekends, I may have 1 hour. And during this time, I watch anything on something on Netflix or YouTube whatsoever, or I read something. But I set my alarm clock. And after 45 minutes, I finish my breakfast and get my stuff done. Then I do my housework. I don't live alone, so it's not that much, but I'm making my bed, dusting a little bit, doing the dishes, whatever. Then I do about between 15 and 45 minutes of yoga, depending on my daily motivation, and then I do a meditation. And that's pretty much it till noon. Then I do what I want. Sometimes I go out, sometimes I just draw a little bit or prepare one of my videos or articles. But it's really easy going. After my meditation, I have a kind of free time, do whatever I want. Then I try to keep my lunchtime between 1 and 2 o'clock, and I don't have much for lunch. In the afternoon or early evening, depending what the rest of the schedule or my plans are, I try to work at least for 2 hours. Working means recording a video, working means practice in some painting skills I don't am not so good in, or learning some new skills I didn't do before. It can also be reading something about things I didn't read before. I read a lot about tarot, I read a lot of psychology, but also about healing stones, or I watch some motivational speakers. I started learning Spanish in an app. I started my YouTube channel. So I try to be productive or learn anything new for at least 2 to 3 hours a day. My dinner time usually is about 8, let's say between 7:30 and 9, and the rest of the day is mine. But I set the alert clock to 11 o'clock. And at 11 o'clock, I turn off my TV. I make myself a cup of tea, or if it's really hot, something else, a cold beverage. I turn off all lights. And I sit down on the balcony, enjoying the night sky. It's getting a little bit colder. Maybe I'm listening to a meditation, or I just do nothing for around about 30 minutes. And then I go to bed because, of course, I do my hygiene stuff you usually do in your bathroom. And I try to be in bed at latest at 1 o'clock. And that's really not that much. Of course, it's all variable. Once in a week, I visit my grandson. Sometimes I have appointments. And of course, sometimes I don't feel like doing yoga, or I don't feel like learning something. But I really try to keep this schedule running through the day. And I really feel good about it because it gives me a kind of purpose or reason. And the other thing is, after all this time, when I'm applying for a job, I can tell them what I did in this time, that I don't didn't even did didn't only binge entire Netflix and whatso else program up and down the row, but that I did something. And I also have a good feeling for myself, because I can say I took care about myself. I did something for me. I did not only let this year pass by without anything good for me. Actually, I had some really great experiences in this time. And so I would invite you to set up your own daily routine. Do you already have one? If so, I would be really interested in reading in the comments about it. If you would like to have some help setting up your schedule or getting some ideas what to do in this time, please contact me. You find my email address in the channel infos. I really would like to support you and help you if I can. I wish you all a productive week. Bye.